So here we are on the home stretch with the Motobecane. All I have to do in this video is fit two shifters, two brake levers, and obviously the four cables, saddle and pedals, and then take the handlebars. And as you can just see now, I popped a chain on it. I adjusted the limit screws on this here of it. Derailleur, the outer limit screw is there, the inner limit screw is here, which I've had to back right off to get it to go far enough in. You know, this being a 6-speed instead of the original 5-speed freewheel that I've put on, it's stretching the limits of this old-fashioned derailleur. Oddly, this is where the cable goes as well, right down here. It's not a mech that I'm familiar with, and I'm not overly impressed, but it's what it had. It's original to the bike, it matches the front one, so I was able as well to get a complimentary cable clamp from there. It's just keeping the theme of the bike to how it left the factory, really. If not the actual specification, at least the theme of it. I'm going to be departing from that with the shifters. The shifters are a Suntour thumb shifters, which you'll see in a minute. And I showed you the bar end brake levers that I'm fitting. Now, just a word about those. Now, in episode one, I mentioned that I was going to use some kind of clever dodge so that I could fit handlebar grips with these levers. That dodge was going to be cut the end out of the handlebar grip so I could slide it fully on, and see, the cable comes out of the lever down here, so the adjuster screws into there, so I would have to bring the cable out underneath the grip. So the idea was to soften the grip in boiling water, insert a cable housing, then slide it on with the cable housing inserted, and then trim the housing off at the end to fit into the adjuster. That would also mean, though, making a notch in the grip for where the adjuster will sit as well. So say that's the end with the end cut off. I'd have to cut a knot out for the cable adjuster to fit in and the cable to come out. And it was just going to look a mess. So I'm going with some taped handlebars, as these grips are intended for. So these are Diacomp grips, and I'm going to use them with taped handlebars, and the Suntour shifters will probably go on the inside of this curve here. I'll play about with those in a minute when I offer them up. Okay, so shifters for the Motobecane. This is what I have in these lovely old style Suntour shifters, my favourite, and that's what I would like on the bike. I intend to have them, if I can show you like that, more or less. There we are. See how they're going to go? That's the idea. However, I'll show you how they work. You have this, which sits on the handlebar. Underneath this is one of the flat spring steel clamps, like the ones that hold brake levers on the old drop handlebar brake levers. These engage, these dimples engage the pins on the back of here to anchor the fulcrum of the lever. A smarter one, more like the one I'm going to be using, as it sits in there on those two pins, and you can alter the position on your handlebars. That is then held in by one of these, which is hollow at one end. It's internally threaded there, M5 threaded there. That drops into here, threads onto the M5 on the inside of the clamp, clamps that down. Then your lever pops on top of there, and this threads onto the inside of that hollow nut, screw, whatever you want to call it, hollow screw I suppose, yeah, that fixing anyway, and that clamps everything together. All tickety-boo, except I don't have any of those clamps. So I'm going to have to go raiding. I'm going to raid the box of old down tube brake levers, drop handlebar brake levers, road type, you know, the old racer levers, and see if any of the clips on there will fit these. Otherwise we're screwed. Or rather we're not, because we've got nothing to screw into. Salvation is at hand. Salvation is at hand. Ignore that one. These are from some old brake lever, I can't even remember that. And they are a fit inside of here. So you see that M5 goes down inside of there, pulls up onto here and clamps that to the handlebars. So we are all systems go. Yes, you might have seen that one. It's not usable. It's not even from one of these. Yep. So yeah, all systems go. Let's get them on. Problem number one. This ain't M5, it's M6. That's M5. Okay. It's also for a bigger handlebar, probably an alloy drop handlebar, larger diameter than this. Here we have one with an M6 inside, and I had another one that was missing its screw inside altogether, so I should be able to do something with that. However, this one is too long. I'm going to have to trim these ends down a bit, I think, but then it'll have nothing to grip with. Oh, this is getting interesting. And problem solved. The solution that was staring me in the face. A solution that I like even better than the Suntour shifters. The Suntours are nice, but they can go on something different. This kind of bike, I just think this outcome is even better, and it doesn't stray away from the Suntour I like so much. Yeah, this is a pair of Suntour down tube shifters, the famous power shifters of some repute, and of course they're for a down tube, so they're far too big for a stem. But what have we got here? We have this strong light extended top nut. See, I haven't bolted them on yet, so I'm going to clean them up first. I just had a look around to see what I had, to see if I had any extra clamps for those other shifters. And these came to hand, and I just thought, well, I could make some kind of... I was going to make a spacer to go around the stem. And then I put them around the stem to see what they were like, see how they positioned themselves. And I slipped them onto there, and that's it. They grip, and they will tighten up nicely. That'll tighten up. They will... stop about here. That'll be the back of their arc, I would think, up to there for higher gear. So I've got a nice arc. I don't mind some shifters, stem shifters. I know a lot of people don't. I've got a Sun Tour stem block on my Bob Jackson, which I adapted to take Campagnolo shifters, and it's fine, particularly for an upright position. I like it. And this kind of, you know, cruisery style that I'm making this bike, it kind of suits it. I think they'll blend in rather well. So I'm going to clean them up and fit them. And then we can steam ahead then, get all four cables on. Okay, we're back on the Motobecane for the final leg. And I've just had a break to do the tricycle axle conversion on the trailer. That's what you see hanging up there. And you've probably seen that video by now. So, I fitted a saddle. Lovely olive green Brooks. It was actually a rep sample, that one, from when I was in the trade. And it's probably not going to be permanent, but it'll be nice and comfy for trials. I've actually nicked it off my Superb and put a brown one on my Superb. So, we have everything in, chain on. The gear mechs are lined up, so the inner and outer limit screws are all lined up, so that goes from the inside to the outside of the freewheel. Ditto the screws on the front. I chose a nice silvery chain just because it's so chromey down there. That whole region of the drivetrain is so chromey, why not? It's turning into quite a bling bike, this one. Mud flap there, it's just had a little bit of shaping, you'll see it better when it's done. And the inverse bar end brake levers are in. These are a simple, you see it in there, simple 4mm Allen key, and there's an expander inside of there. And they're made, as you can see, by Diacomp. Probably not how you pronounce it. Diacompe, something like that. I don't know. Right. I also replaced the rear cable hanger with a nice MAFAC one. It says Depose, it says MAFAC on the other side. Depose is, it's like patented, basically. The patent has been deposited at the patent office. That's what it means. When you see Depose on a French part, it's the patent indication. So, there's nothing I can do now to procrastinate before doing the job I hate most on a bike, which is the cables. Sorry, second most on a bike. The one I hate most is wiring dynamos. But yeah, we need a set of cables. Excuse me for a moment. I've got this. This was just a cheap set of cables off eBay. Now I have big drums full of housing and drums full of cables of different sorts. However, I wanted some white housing. For the price of getting a couple of meters of white housing, I could get a full kit of four cables, two gear and two brake, with all the white housing necessary, off of the old flea bay, and some bits of extra plastic ferrules that aren't going to be used. I'll use metal ones. So it made sense. Yes, technically I am going to be using brake housing for my gears. It's okay, you can use that. Not recommended for index gears. There's just, you might get a tiny bit of slop and flex in it. It might put your settings out by up to a millimeter, which matters for a 12-speed index. Certainly doesn't matter for this. This is six at the back, by the way, and two at the front, and completely friction, so it ain't gonna matter one jot that I'm using brake. Unless I come to any gear cable stops that are drilled for the slightly narrower gear cable, then I might just have to run a drill into a hole, but I don't think so. I think all the stops are standard on this bike. So for instance, on the cable there, there's a cable guide and stop. I don't think the holes are going to be any different from the one up there. One is for a brake and one's for a gear. I think I'm worrying about unnecessary things here to procrastinate and avoid getting on with the job in hand. So we're going to need some housing from each of these down to here. So the first piece of housing is going to come out of the bottom of there. See, that's where it comes out of. So the cable wraps around the lever, comes out of the bottom. It's going to go down and straight down to that stop, with obviously some curve in it to compensate for steering. Never make it tight. This one is the rear, so it'll come down to this stop, then there'll be this open wire this end, then more white housing down to another stop there, then more open cable, then another stop there, and more white housing up and round in the traditional loop to the rear derailleur. So one, two, three pieces of housing on that cable. The other one, the front, is the same piece of housing down to this stop. Then it comes down to the other side of this. This is a double, into some housing again, and the housing will go all the way up to the bottom of the mech here. That's two pieces for there. Front brake, dead easy. One piece of housing down to the hanger here. It will be taped to the handlebars to about this point, because I'll be taping the bars probably to here. But the brake cable will emerge about here, I think, to give it a nice clear run down to the anchor. Then the other side brake cable, again, it'll be taped under the tape, under the handlebar tape, and round onto here, stop there, open wire along the top tube to another stop here, piece of cable to that anchor there. So three pieces in total for the brakes, one for the front, two for the rear. The cables required for this kind of lever, or just your normal barrel nipple, the most common and garden type. The cables needed for these shifters are the road bike type with the pear nipple. Fortunately, I got a universal cable set, otherwise I'd have had to buy a set of road and a set of mountain. But as I say, I have millions of wires, it's the outer I wanted. Right, I'm going to put you in the tripod and get cracking. Under the stop there, there's a little curled over piece of metal which acts as a guide to stop it jumping off the channel, which is in the shifter. There we are. So I've shoved it under there. I can feel that it's now going in and out. And now repeat other side. So feed it into the lever, then pull the lever back, pull it through, make sure it's seated nicely in the channel, under that piece of turned over metal, find the other end which is falling down on the floor somewhere, way out of reach. Now doing this totally blind so that you can see. I'm not seeing, so that you can. Oh, do come along. There we are. There we are. And don't forget to put them against the stop in high gear position and low gear position. Because that's where you're taking your adjustment from at the other end. Now we need to start cutting some outer. Well, this is good. The set for provides two sets of outer, one brake and one gear. So I should use the gear. I didn't expect it, it was only about a fiver this set. Very good. A word about cable cutters. These are proper bicycle cable cutters, just a budget model. Very good. And they simply lock like a pair of garden secateurs almost. Very similar to secateurs. This is what I tend to use. These are electrical side cutters. I just find them a bit more efficient. And these tend not to close up the metal inner as much as these do. These tend to leave this metal inner closed up, and I've got to put a little bradawl in to open it out. You can use a nail, end of a bicycle spoke, something like that, to make sure that this is all opened out and you haven't got any bits of the outer that you've chopped off sticking inside to catch on the cable. Right, we want about, I'd say we want about this. Can you see that? You can't really see what I'm doing there at the bottom. I'll show you in a sec. Now, there's a little angle on there. That's going to sit in that angle. It'll get a ferrule on. And there. And make the lengths identical for the sake of smartness and a professionally built appearance. Good, that's got a ferrule on. Ferrule on this end. Find the end of this very long cable. Thread it in. This has a waxy lubricant on it, I can feel it. Otherwise I would be waxing it myself. I like wax for cables. I like wax for a lot of things on a bicycle, to be honest. Right, just going to poke that, pull it out and pull the wire through to make sure it's through. There we are. Pull everything through, that'll bring itself round and in. The first piece of the first cable is home. Repeat for the other side. The other way of doing it is ferrule onto the wire first, then housing, then the other ferrule. That's all very well, but you must make sure that the ferrules are properly seated onto the housing at either end. Because if there's any slop, not quite fully seated down, see, it's sitting on top like that, then at some point it's going to work its way down and put your gear adjustment out. Or your brake adjustment, depending which cable it is. Like we've got one there doing the same thing. Make sure that's pushed properly home. And into the other stop. I used to be so quick at doing this, but there are no prizes for quickness when you're building yourself a nice bike. Now down to the bottom. Same routine with the ferrules. Because this is a cable stop and it's not a slotted one, don't forget the rookie error is to not poke this through before putting the gubbins on. When I used to train youngsters, and I trained proper bike mechanics as well, with Velotec. When I used to do that, that was one of the errors that people would make, and then you'd have to undo everything, do it all again, meaning that you wouldn't do it a second time. Now that's interesting. That is not drilled big enough for a ferrule. Okay. It is, however, big enough for the housing because I just tried it. So I'm going to, that's already through. I wonder if I should, no, it's not going to fit in there. It's not going to go in. I think I'm just going to have to use housing only. Don't like doing it, but this looks a fairly accurate cable stop, so hopefully that's going to act as a ferrule anyway. I didn't like having to do that. And now try not to get any kinks in the cable. Into that end, into that end. And that's that piece in. Because the next stop is so close behind. Can you see that? I'm just off camera. The next stop is so close behind it that I've just taken the wire straight to there. To here, look. There we are. Cut the final bit of housing for this cable. Again, I've tried a ferrule in there, won't go. I could have got some special gear ferrules, but as I say, this seems to be pretty good, and we're not dealing with index gears here. The mech has its own ferrule on the adjuster. There we are. Your view of this is going to be really rubbish. Just bear with me. I'm actually working blind. Really, I should go and stand behind the work stand to give both of us a better view of what's going on. That would mean moving things. It's now after 11 o'clock at night. I have my limits. You know the routine by now. Pull this through into the cable stop, pulling it tight. Bring it round above the bottom brackets and it will curl up naturally into the cable stop on the mech, which has its own ferrule again. And there we are. I just need to clamp that cable in, and that's the gears cabled up. Right, simply pop that through from the back onto here, and I've cut my piece of outer already. I'll show you why I measured it the way I measured it when I get it on. I'm using ferrules here because this lever doesn't have its own ferrule. Make sure that the barrel nipple on the end is properly engaged and the ferrule is properly engaged in the lever. And then this cable anchor here is a slotted one, so I can slot that straight in. Magically moved around the bike. It gives you a better view and allows me to do this without reaching across you. Into the little adjuster that lives in this cable hanger that is next to useless as an adjuster but essential for holding the cable. It has its own, it forms its own ferrule, so no ferrule necessary. Now this cable has been cut because I'm now going to tape it to the handlebars, and it's going to go under the handlebar tape. Now that has now reached the brake, that can sit there now until I come to set the brakes up. And on to the next one, which I have handy already set up in its hanger, in its stop. Can you see that? Are you able? Yes, you're still within the vision of the camera. It is rather late at night now, so I'm forgetting things. Right, there's the end of it. Just popped that out of the stop. There we are. Hold it into here, push the ferrule properly into the hole on the lever. It's a little bit of persuasion and it's in. Give that a nice sharp tug on there, which I will do when I've got it into the brake as well, and I'm setting the brake up, they will get a good tug. I've done all this with you tonight and forgot about Tinkercam. We could have been doing quite a lot of this on Tinkercam. So here we are now. Come on. Through there first. Do not be tempted to just thread it into the outer without making sure it's screw. Now that's not very nice in there. This is nicer in this end. Yeah, that's a nicer end. Put the cable in there and let it poke its way out of there. Right. Now put the ferrule on, because this hanger doesn't have a ferrule in. Not happy with the end of that cable. It's not there through the last hole. Oh, it's dropped off. It's so loose now, it's dropped off. That's fine. Better too loose than too tight. Another little fiddly job that I've done is just taping these cables to the handlebars, and that's where they will get their tape attached. So if the tape comes to about here, this cable will exit about here. This cable is fine to take all the way along. But obviously white handlebar tape is going to be done last. There is just one more little trick to do. I'm going to finish the ends of here with an old-fashioned twining method, and I'll show you that as I do it. But the bike is finished at last. Well, it's been quite a road, this one. A lot longer than I thought it was going to be, but here's the result. I really like these French Boulevardier handlebars. You can buy these from Nitto as the Bosco, and from Velo Orange as the Left Bank. That's a little French demi-porter front rack. And as you can see, I got rid of all that horrible nail varnish on the top tube. I'm sorry for this machinery going in the background. Isn't it always the case when you're trying to record sound? I do like the look of that little number plate on the back. There's a cute little light going on just above it, which you'll see on the next video. It rides beautifully. A couple of little things to tighten up, that's fine. I'll sort that out. And the next time you see this bike will be in a few days' time, and I'm going to take it out for its first proper ride. I'll put its French bags on it. I'm going to fit a kickstand as well, that's something I forgot. And you'll see it in all its glory. I think I'll probably take it down to the seafront and promenade with it. Why not? So thanks for staying with it this far anyway. And stick around for the first ride video. Please share it on your social media. My Facebook's down again at the moment, so stick it all over Facebook. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.